sordid.
You see
my soul is resting.
I know it's just
a blessing.
Tonight we praise you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hey. Say,
I'm living in the light now. I'm living in the light now.
I'm living in the light now. I'm living in the light now.
Hey.
I'm living in the light now. 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 I'm living in the light now.
Come on, how many of you have been through some things in 2022, but are here tonight because we are free?
Conversation of all my enemies.
God not just for me, but so everyone around me can have everything they need. Let all these folks that's with me, God, have everything they need. Let all these folks that's with me, God, have everything they need.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
We got everything!
Thank you, Jesus!
Hallelujah!
We got everything!
Everything!
Hallelujah!
We got everything!
God, we believe for it.
it's 2022. If you don't have a packet like this, please raise your hands. We are getting ready to take the very last offering of this year. I welcome streaming Facebook, YouTube, all around the world. We welcome you right here to Family Christian Center in Munster, Indiana. In this auditorium, we're preparing to return back our tithe and offering the very last time of 2022. You can join with us and be blessed, going to the giving icon, clicking on that, and then follow all the instructions. Well, if you have been faithful in your giving for 2022, you have every right to march into the throne room of God and remind him of what you have done this year. It says in Psalms 119, David writes, "Remember, God, your word to your servant, in which you have made me hope." How many have been hoping on the word of God? "Because that is my comfort and my affliction, that your promises gives me life." How many know God has been faithful in the good times and in the bad times? He has blessed. And if you've been faithful in your giving, God is going to continue to bless. I don't know if you know or not, but it says in James that on the day of judgment, your money will rise up and testify against you. The good thing is, it will testify for you. It also says that his blessings are new every morning. You know what's good about that? Morning starts at midnight. At the last stroke of midnight tonight, when you walk out this building, new blessings will be waiting for you as you drive out the parking lot. How many are ready to give to God tonight in 2022? As you prepare to give, here comes our band.
hilltops of Judea. Prepare the way of the Lord. He who is coming after me is mightier than I. Make his path straight. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. And behold, I am with you always.
Yeah. the struggle, you think God's forgotten about you. Here's some pain medicine. Let's go! You in your car, you at the house, on your job. Be encouraged, boo. Come on! Chapter 7, verses 16 and 17. Yes, sir. They shall hunger no more, neither shall they thirst anymore. Preach, preacher. For God shall wipe away, yes, sir, every tear from their eyes. Yes, sir. Get ready for the revolution. Come on. Come on. What you say? Come on.
Straight from a page of your favorite author. And the weather's so breezy. Man, why can't life always be this easy? She in the mirror dancing so sleazy. I get a call like, where are you, Yeezy? And try to hit you with the old wapty. Till I got flashed by the paparazzi. These got me. I hate these more
as
than
I recall, I know you love to
century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. I got the power making life so exciting.
Oh, tonight has been so incredible with all of the incredible music, the dance team, and all of the good things that we have experienced that we have done this year. I am so excited to introduce an incredible, wonderful group that is coming to us right now. David and Nicole and Gracie Binion, of course, their drummer, and all of their team is here tonight. David and Nicole pastor in Dallas, Texas area, and they're doing an incredible job from TBN to Daystar as they write songs, and great things that are happening. We're also thrilled tonight to have Lisa Binion. And of course, Lisa and David, before David and Nicole were married, were right here, music pastors, and they were right here at Family Christian Center. In many years, we experienced. In fact, Jesus was played by David Binion when David was here. And we're so excited that they are back tonight. We love them. Everybody, get on your feet and let's welcome David and Nicole and Gracie Binion.
Woo! Happy New Year! Okay, they told me they needed a couple minutes to get all ready to go. You're good to go? Well, you told me to take a little couple minutes, and so now I'm already geared up. Because I have to just say, Pastor Steve, I love you. I love you. I love you. So I think it was like 25 years ago that Nicole and I left Family Christian Center to answer the call of God on our lives. But I will tell you that the high water mark of encounters with the Lord happened in this church. I am who I am today because of my life and my foundation in this church with this insanely talented pastor with ADD. I'm just thrilled to be back in the house. I almost feel like Sophia on Color Purple when she came home for Christmas. Remember? She got out of the car and her little kids came up and she started crying and she says, Mama, why are you crying? And she said, because I don't know y'all no more. We have to change that. Okay, I see some faces that I know, but I see faces I don't know, and that we can't let that happen, all right? I promise to be your best friend if you'll let me be. We are just so thrilled to be in this house, and we're going to make ourselves at home. Everybody ain't standing up. Pastor said on the video, stand up. You got to stand up, everybody on your feet, at least for this first couple of songs, all right? Are y'all ready? That was underwhelming. Are you ready? Let's do it. Here we go.
Faith sees a miracle, looking for a home.
I believe in miracles. miracle.
I believe in a miracle.
I can see a miracle.
Faith sees a miracle.
Looking for a home.
Looking for a home.
Of the kingdom,
yeah.
We open the doorway of heaven.
Oh.
We're holding the keys of the kingdom.
Yeah.
We open the doorway of heaven.
Said we're holding the
we're
keys,
holding the keys of the kingdom,
and we open
the doorway of heaven. We're holding the keys of the kingdom.
Rise up, I am a walking, talking, living
comes the glory of the Lord.
Jesus, Jesus.
Here comes the glory of the Lord, sweeping in the room.
Come on, everybody, declare that with us. Here he comes.
Here comes the glory of the Lord. Here comes the glory of the Lord, sweeping in. Oh. Here comes the glory of the Lord. Here comes the glory of the Lord, sweeping in.
Is coming now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Changing the atmosphere, rolling in like a cloud.
Oh.
The King of Glory.
Here comes the glory of the Lord. Here comes the glory of. Comes the glory of the Lord, sweeping in the room.
Heaven is wonderful.
Yeah.
Healing is breaking out right here, right now. Miracle signs and wonders. Here he comes.
Here comes the glory of the Lord.
Come on, sing it.
Here comes the glory of the Lord, sweeping in the room. Just once more declare, here comes the glory of the Lord. Here comes the glory of the Lord, sweeping in the room.
King of glory, fill this place. We just want to be with you. We just want to be with you.
Oh!
Just wanna be with you.
We just wanna be with you.
So I'll sing hallelujah until you come again.
Oh yeah.
And I'll dance in your presence until.
Hallelujah.
up a shout of worship. I want my sister to come. She's over there somewhere. Come up here. She's going to do a final song with us. Well, maybe not a final song. It'll be the final song. But before we do, we have to do just a little chorus of this.
I've come to pour my praise on him like oil from Mary's alabaster box. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and dry them with my hair. 'Cause you were there the night he found me. You did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his love around me, and you don't know the cost of the oil. You don't know the cost of my praise. You don't know the cost of the oil in my alabaster. Just had a memory. I think I was 16 years old on a New Year's Eve service at Family Christian Center on Broad Street when we heard that song for the first time, sung by the writer Janis Jo Strand. And I was wrecked. We were all wrecked. It was about over 30 years ago. And there are some songs that stand the test of time. They never get old. And that is one of them. And I just want to say, as Lisa's coming, I just want to, I know David has just shared our love, but I just want to say, when I'm seeing the young people up here dancing, I was thinking about what a lifesaver it is to have a church that provides a place for our young people to be a part, to have community. And that was my life here at Family Christian Center as in my teenage years. And so thank you for that. But we're gonna break into rain dance, I think.
And we have to say, Pastor Melody's watching on live stream, wherever the camera is. Pastor Melody, we love you. Yeah. We FaceTimed you already, but we just wanna say we love you. You do too, okay. There's five of us love her.
I love her the most. You know it's true.
Okay, so Pastor, when he called in to see if we could come, we went through the whole conversation, we worked out the details, and he said, but I want you to sing Rain Dance. Anybody heard Rain Dance? How many have not heard Rain Dance? Say, oh, you're about to hear it. And we're gonna finish with this song. Are y'all ready? Here we go.
Believe the promises spoken by the prophet Joel, the former and the latter rain would come and flood our thirsty souls. We've been praying for the rain, praying for the rain to fall upon our city, Lord. Come and overtake us all. You don't wanna miss your chance. Everybody,
everybody, rain.
Rain, Lord, we're crying out for rain. asking you for rain. Lord, send down the rain. Indiana needs some rain. Lord, you promised us the rain. You don't wanna miss your chance.
Everybody,
everybody rang dang.
Here we go.
Oh. Ooh.
Hey.
We've been looking to the sky, seen a cloud just like a hand. Heard it with our spirit ears. Abundant rain will drench the land. So we're gonna nudge the heart that holds the water in a heave and move it with the crazy praise and break the mountains of the deep. Miss your chance.
Everybody,
everybody rain dance.
Now you gotta do this with us. Everybody.
Who?
You got a good healthy boo? Come on, here we go.
Who?
Come on, once more.
Who?
Okay, now once more.
Hey! We don't
former things, nor consider the things of old.
Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The beast of the field will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches, because I give waters in the wilderness and rivers in the desert to give drink to my people, my chosen. This people I have formed for myself. They shall declare my praise.
I'm just glad to be at the New Year's Eve service tonight. I can't hear you. I'm just glad to be here tonight. Give it up for David, Nicole, Lisa, and Madison and Gracie. Give it up for them. Give it up for Jesus. He played Jesus many years. I don't know where he's at. They're probably getting a drink of water. We're so glad to have Marty tonight. That is Nicole's mother. She's part of our staff for many, many years, and we're so glad that she is here tonight. And I want you to know that before the balloons drop and before the explosions go off, there's a word that God wants to give every one of you right now in the name of Jesus. There were so many memories when David, and you have to understand that David was a part of our church for many years. And I reached over to him, and all of you band and all of you people, you know, I said, now, David, you should be proud of the fact because you're a part of the foundation of this church. And a lot of people say we would never make it, we would go under and et cetera, and banks rejected us and all kinds of things. But I'm here to tell the devil he is a liar. Somebody help me say amen. I remember we got one service tomorrow. This never happens, they tell me, in 11 years. Last Sunday I was messed up because we decided that you would have church home with us and streaming, but I was a mess. That'll never happen again. I was a mess. I know we came to you live in many, and we had more response. We had more response than we've ever had on streaming, and I thank God for all of that. But I just miss. In fact, I've got the same spirit as David when he said, I was glad when they said unto me. Do I have anybody else that says, I am glad they said unto me? And I know they're trying to popularize that going to church is not as popular. But I want to tell you, there's nothing like coming to church. And everybody that loves church, shout a great big amen. There's David. David, you did great. You did great. Now, if we had a lot of time, David, you know my favorite song. You know what? You know, I know you didn't write it, but I love that song. Got to serve somebody. And nobody can play it and sing it like David. Got to serve somebody. Bobby Dylan wrote that, I believe. And David is so talented. He's got a brand new book coming out. Everybody get online, get ready to get it. He's also got a brand new worship series that's coming out. And they're getting ready to do a great album on the book of Revelation. The Holy Spirit spoke to me, and I've only got about 23 minutes, and I want to tell you something very, very important. I want to tell you before midnight hits Central Standard Time, something is about to happen. And I know we say that when the beginning of a new year, but I'm going to tell you tonight, I declare it's going to happen in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Stinson. God said, I'm going to do a new thing. And in the last few days, the Lord has spoken to my heart, and he says, tell the church and tell all of those that will hear this word, I'm getting ready to do a new beginning. I'm getting ready to do something that your eye has not seen, nor your ear has not heard, nor has it been recorded in the heart of man. And when I would begin to pray and begin to seek God in early Friday morning at 6 o'clock, there was just a huge crowd here in prayer. The Holy Spirit just really kept telling me, you need to get ready. I'm going to do, do a new beginning. Now, I'm a numbers man because in the Bible, there is a book called Numbers. I study numbers because numbers are relevant and God speaks through numbers. I can go through all of the numbers and tell you what they mean. I should say not all of them, but the first 15 or 20 to 25. Immediately when I heard the Lord said he was going to do a new beginning, I said, that's great, God. I want some things to end. I want my debt to end. I want my sickness to end. I want my bitterness to end. I want my unforgiveness to end. Some things I want to end. Because without an ending, there is no beginning. And when the Holy Spirit spoke to me and said, you tell them tonight, whoever hears this voice and whoever hears this sound prophetically, that I'm going to do a new beginning. And I want to tell someone and tell all of you that immediately after I heard that, I began to look the numbers up. And I'm, you know, I wanted to know what 2023 means. 20, I know, means a sign of change, a big shift taking place in our lives. Give me number 20. And the minute we entered into the 2000, notice the shift, the COVID. The unexplained began to take place. Then I looked up 23. 23, and I was so amazed. 23 means new beginning, revolution, and transformation. If you want to add these up, it equals 7. And that's a number that God has always given us good instruction. That 7 is complete. If you follow as logically and you begin to follow the revelations, or I should say the wording of commentators and dispensationalists and different people who study the Word of God, they have different views on when Jesus is going to come and how it's going to happen and when it's going to happen. You'll always hear 7. You'll hear the words seven tribulation years. And some will tell you that in the first 3.5 years, there is something that happens in the 7-year tribulation. There are some that believe that the rapture will take place before the tribulation. Some believe that after the tribulation. Regardless of where you stand, when you study numbers, you will always notice that in the middle of a 7, there is revelation. For instance, in the 7, those that believe that there's going to be an Antichrist, that in the first 3.5 years, they accept him, and then in the 3.5 years, they realize he is not the one, supposedly, as commentators and believers would like us to understand. But I want to bring this point to you that we are in, somehow, we are in 2023-7, and I believe right in the middle of this 7, there is a revelation, because in the last 3 years, we've been through some high waters, and we've been through some shaking, but something is about to happen. In the midst of 7, if I can use that terminology. And I'm going to lean in real hard to these numbers in the next few minutes to tell you that 23 signifies beginnings, revelation, a revolution, and transformation. Change, progress, innovation. I'm reminded of Churchill said these words. Now, this is not the end. It is not even the beginning of the end, but it is perhaps the end of the beginning. Because you must understand that before there is a beginning, there must be an end. And most things end, and the saddest ones are the ones that don't have a beginning. And I want to declare to you that when God gives you a beginning, it don't matter who else tries to give you a beginning. There are three things that are going to happen in the next few moments that I believe. I believe a new beginning is about to take place for those that are saying, I'm fed up with what I have been through. Some things are good, but there's a whole lot of things I'm done with. I'm done living mediocrely for God. I'm done just haphazardly going through life. I've been praying and I've been wanting the dream to come to pass, but I'm ending all the negativity that's been in my ears and what surrounds me in my life and all of the murmuring and the complaining and the griping and what I do have and what I don't have. I'm tearing the rear view mirror off of my vehicle. I'm looking straight ahead, pressing toward the mark of the high calling. Can I get anybody that says I'm ready for a new beginning? How will that happen? Will that happen at 12 o'clock Central Standard Time, Pastor, when the balloons drop? Is that what's going to happen? Well, first of all, I want to tell you, you got to make up in your mind that you want something you have never had. You got to make up in your mind to say, I know my God is about to do something I have never seen. I got to get somebody in this house to open up your mouth and to declare the end of what the devil has been doing in your life. I'm tired of you messing with my children. I'm tired of you messing with my marriage. I'm tired of you messing with my staff. I'm tired of you messing with my relatives and my husband and my wife. Am I talking to anybody? I'm tired of the enemy coming in like a flood. But I read somewhere in the Bible that when the enemy comes in like a flood, God raises up a standard. Somebody shout standard. Let go of your yesterday, because your yesterday is let go of you. Take the first step of faith, even if you don't even see the whole staircase. Just take the step. Begin now. I want to declare a revelation that came to me in what I'm telling you, and you're going to have to catch it quick. I discovered that when you want a beginning, angels in heaven, the splendor of the power of the heavens, hears you in the balcony, you watching me, you to the left or the right or on the platform. When you declare, somebody shout, declare a beginning, to declare, I'm going to believe, I am going to get out of debt, I am going to overcome, I am going to break out of this addiction, I am tired of being just normal. And when you declare, it is a new beginning, which we all can retreat to the resolution of in a few minutes, that yes, there is a new year coming, and 23 means new beginnings. But to my shocking surprise, and the word of God is always fresh and it is always incredible, that when you declare tonight at midnight, I'm going to have a new beginning, money's going to come, favor's going to come in my life, something is about to switch, there's a revolution. Oh, I'm going to talk to somebody who's hungry for a new beginning. Somebody that's ready to break out of the mold. Somebody that's ready to say, I want it, I want it, I believe it. Am I talking to anybody in this house that declares, I want that beginning? And what I'm about to tell you, you got to catch quickly. Because I want to tell you tonight that every time you claim a beginning. I'm going to marry you, the woman you have chosen to marry, the husband you have chosen to marry, the beginning of a new relationship. A child is born, a beginning to say this child will be incredible. A moment in which you start believing for the impossible. I'm going to tell you, angels break rank, jump over the balconies of heaven, and stand at attention to the words you proclaim, waiting for the direction of God, giving them the direction to order your steps. For angels are ministering spirits. What are you talking about? In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. In the book of Job, the Bible said when God said it was in the beginning, the Bible said the angels shouted for joy. When Abraham was about to kill his son and it looked like this was the end, the Bible said Abraham believed it was only the beginning. An angel dispatched out to the corridors of heaven, because when somebody utters, "This is a new beginning," there will be an angel that will show up. You're not hearing me. I discovered in the Bible that the Bible has declared that every time you begin to come to your end and you begin to say, "I'm believing for the best beginning," that angels show up. When Daniel was in the lion's den and it looked like it was the end, but it was only the beginning. But the next morning the king said, "Daniel, are you alive?" He said, "Yes, I declared a beginning," and an angel showed up and shut the mouth of the lion. When it looked like Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, it was the end. They stepped in and said, "We'll not bow down, we'll not kneel, but we will believe and say it is only the beginning." And when the Bible says the king looked in, he said, "How many did we throw into that fiery furnace? I see one, two, three, and I see the fourth one." When you speak, it is a new beginning. Angels show up. Oh, you're not hearing me. Look through all the scripture verses. I was amazed when Jesus was born. It was just the beginning. And the Bible says the angels broke out to the shepherds and they begin to sing "Peace on Earth," because they always show up when someone says beginnings. For the Bible has declared to believe as one should believe, and that is you should not be silent. This is what the Holy Spirit says. David said, "Therefore I speak because I believe." Apostle Paul said, "We have the same spirit of faith. I believe, and therefore I have spoken. We also believe, and therefore we speak. In the beginning was the Word." The only way your beginning is going to be able to be manifested is you're going to have to open up your mouth, because in your mouth is life and death. In your mouth is you can speak to every mountain. Who am I talking to that will not be silent in this house tonight? And if you keep your mouth closed, you need to have a refreshing of redemption, because the Bible said, "Let the redeemed say so." So if you don't have any redemption, you probably don't have a shout. But if you have redemption by the blood of the Lamb, you can shout. When Jesus was in the wilderness and the devil came to him and tempted him, it looked like it it was the end, but it was only the beginning. And the Bible says in Matthew, an angel was sent. Oh, you're not hearing me. When Jesus was in the garden, and it was at the end, and he said, Father, let this cup pass from me, wiping blood on his gown, sweating drops of blood in his body, rambling and holding upon the garden floor, holding rocks and begging for his disciples to pray, and they went to sleep until he got to the point that he said, I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to let them nail nails in my hand and strip me nude and beat the flesh off of my back. I'm not going to let them put nails in my hands and a crown of thorns. It was already prophesied, and he had read what was going to happen. And he looked up, and it looked like it was the end. But God said, no, it's just the beginning. And when beginning happened, an angel was sent. And when the angel was sent, he strengthened him. What are you trying to say, Pastor? I'm trying to get you to open up your mouth and say, there is a new beginning going to happen in my life. And let an angel, let the angels declare their glory. In the book of Acts, when Jesus was ascended on the Mount of Galilee, the Bible said they stood up and gazed and thought it was the end. But then the Bible said the angels came and said, this is not the end, this is only the beginning. But when, as you have seen him go away, he shall come back in like manner. What I'm saying to you this evening and minutes before 2023, if you will declare the spirit of faith, I believe, and therefore I speak. You're not getting it, so let me see if this one works. The Bible tells me I have the right, if I have the spirit of faith, to call those things that are not as though they were. I need 25 people to stand up and shout hallelujah. Just 25. That's too many. Sit down. That's too many. Sit down. You got to get sick and tired of talking the way you all have been talking. You need to start talking, I am a child of God. I am the head and not the tail. I made mistakes, but I serve a God who believes in forgiveness. And he forgets what he forgives me of. I cannot allow hate. I cannot allow jealousy. I cannot allow unforgiveness to be in my life. Because if he is for me, who can be against me? Somebody open up your mouth. It's almost time. I said it's almost time. Herod said, kill Peter. Kill Peter. We beheaded James. Just kill Peter. You can read this in the book of Acts. And when Peter got into prison and 16 guards were chained to him, Peter thought, they killed James, they're going to kill me. But Peter went to sleep. You can't go to sleep if you think bad things are going to happen to you. But when you know who you are, who am I talking to? I said, when you know who you are, I'm going to get excited. I can't get some of you excited. Let me see if I can get you excited about 23. For the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. I am good and mad at the devil. I am good and mad at the devil. I am furious that a soccer ball can get more praise than at church with Jesus. While you fold your arms saying, I don't think that moves me, when I ought to tell you that he is here. I heard David and Nicole. They said the glory is here. I felt the glory. But it's not going to knock you down. You're going to have to say, I believe the glory is on me. Anybody ready for a new beginning? The moment you declare, it is time, it is time, I believe, therefore I speak, I believe, therefore I speak. I got 3 minutes, and I got some shoes at my grandson's. Told me, you may be seated so the back can see you, or the back people can see you. They said, Papa, this is the style. Wear these with your suit. And I looked, and they say, Alexander McQueen. He must be a believer or something. He said, my grandchildren, this is the style. You don't no longer wear black shoes. You wear what's in style. And I've come to tell you tonight, this is a new beginning. I have never, ever wore Alexander. And Alexander, if you're watching us, send your tithe in. I just want to tell you, change is in me. Revolution is in me. Transition is in me. And I want to tell Malachi and all of my grandchildren, it does feel good. I may be here tomorrow at 12:30 with a brand new pair of Alexandras. It feels weird. It feels funny. But when God gets ready to put a new beginning in you, the old wineskin has got to go, and the new wineskin has got to happen. I need you to stand up and shout hallelujah. Now, I can't promise you I will never wear these again. But tonight, I'm not looking back. Tonight, change is coming. It feels a little bit uncomfortable. I don't like what I'm saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. And if God be for me, who can be against me? And if there's no weapon formed against me that shall prosper, then I'm ready to declare there's a new beginning. Can I get somebody? There's a new beginning. I got 2 minutes. You got 2 minutes. 2 minutes. 2 minutes to declare there's a new beginning. When Hezekiah was at the temple, he put the letter out that King Sennacherib was coming to kill him. 185,000 surrounded Jerusalem. But God said to Hezekiah, it's a new beginning. And when he said that, he sent one angel. And the Bible said one angel killed 185,000 Syrians.
Somebody better get ready to say it's a new beginning. It's a new beginning. For in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. I want you to speak to your mountain. Declare to your debt. Cancer, you got to go. Sickle cell anemia, you got to go. Unforgiveness, you got to go. I need somebody to shout new beginning. Look at the angels. They're coming. They're coming. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, new beginning. Turn the lights off. New beginnings. New beginnings. New beginnings. Oh my God, new beginnings. Blow this place up. New beginnings. New beginnings. Shout it out, new beginnings. New beginnings. Yeah, new beginnings. I got a new beginning. New beginnings. New beginnings. Somebody leap for joy. It's a new beginning. It's a new beginning. It's a revolution. Yes, it's a new beginnings. It's a new beginnings. It's a new beginnings. Let the balloons fall as we shout new beginnings. Man, we got fireworks. Come on. Come on. I'm ready for a new year. I'm ready for a new season. Woo! My Lord. Oh, yes. I claim it. It's a new beginning. I'm speaking in my life. Change is coming. The glory of God is upon me.
No yes. God,
come on, clap your hands. It's a
there
new beginning.
No one above you.
New
no
beginning.
No one beside you. Nobody like you.
Look at the balloons.
There
yes.
will be no other God before you. No one, no one, no one.
Yeah, new
no
beginnings.
One, no one,
new
no
beginnings.
One, no one, no
look at the
one.
Look like it's coming, but it's coming.
No one,
it's coming.
No one.
Come on, Happy New Year! Happy New Year! It's a new beginning! 2023! 23! New beginnings! New beginnings! Happy New Year! Woo! Come on! Happy New Year!
What do you think of my shoes? Happy New Year! Happy New Year, balcony! Happy New Year! In the balcony!
like Jesus.
You're the best church.
Can't nobody do it like Jesus. Can't nobody. Oh, my miracle is coming.
My miracle is coming.
My miracle is coming.
My miracle is coming.
My blessing
Happy
is coming.
New Year.
My blessing is coming. My blessing
Thank you, Jesus.
My blessing is coming. Oh, my new beginning's coming.
Happy
my
New Year.
My double portion is here. 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 My double portion is here.